I go now? Ooh, we can run.
The Prescott dormitory? Good lord, Nathan's family owns my dorm?
Jeez.
The Prescott dormitory? Good lord, Nathan's family owns my dorm?
I forgot what I was doing. Warren. Oh yeah, the parking lot. Where's the parking lot? Wait, is this a map? No? Whatever. I was winging it. Oh, parking lot.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
What do I do? What do I do?
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us. This is official campus business.
Excuse me. You shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey. Hey, nobody is bullying anybody.
I just saw you bullying her.
You're part of the problem, Missy. Remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you.
You scared of a little girl.
Anytime. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
Fuck that guy anyway, whatever. Screw Officer Dickhead. Jeez, can you walk any slower? There you go.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
What up?
Hi, Julia.
So lonely.
How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
I'm so sorry.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha.
As a joke.
I think
okay.
Warren wants your attention.
He usually does.
Like, huh? Juliet. Here's a picture of my dick. LOL, just kidding. What a douche. What does that say? Tard. I think that's just a scribble.
I wonder how long before Samuel has to reclaim.
Tard. So funny, haha.
Yo, Max, check it out.
Here you go,
what
fool.
Up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
They look like shit.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time.
Only 60 miles away.
But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Wait, what did he say?
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that, Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
The movie booty? Or the booty movie? Noah.
No, I've been way too busy with class.
I tried to check it out.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, Drama Queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
This guy's a freaking weirdo.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
Okay.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is
between even if you I and did, you probably wouldn't believe me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now.
I told him the truth.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
Yeah, no shit.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should God, talk I hate this to guy. Somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step.
Take a step back. Nathan Prescott.
You're gonna back up off
me,
motherfucker.
What to do?
Get away from her, dude.
Oh.
Hey, leave him alone.
Nobody tells me what to do.
I just did, bitch.
Parents, not the principal, or that whore
right
in the bathroom.
Max? Chloe?
No way.
Oh shit, it's that chick.
Again.
Come on, kick the shit out of him.
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
What a privileged asshole.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh.
You should be thankful I saved your life.
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
What freak?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
Hipstergirl.com.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry.
sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle.
I mean, it's not that big of a school.
A shy, cliche geek.
How could she not know?
I would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me.
What?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes.
I thought I fixed
my
camera.
My camera has officially taken a shit.
Unless you just broke it.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
He's a tiny tool with a tiny tool.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Home, shit, home.